According to the Archbishop of the Church of Uganda, Dr. Stephen Kazimba Mgalu, Ugandans shouldn't engage in corruption if they really know and believe in God. The Archbishop was bothered that despite the continuous talks condemning corruption, the vice has instead persisted.
We talk and talk and talk about this challenge in our country, but nothing seems to change. There is no power greater than death. Corruption is a stronger force, but it's not stronger than death. And Jesus has defeated death. More than that, he has risen to empower us to defeat the demon of corruption.
He has advised those implicated in the Iron Sheet saga to use the Easter period to reflect on their lives by returning the iron sheets so that they could benefit the vulnerable people of Karamoja.
Would not steal things from people who have even less than us. How can you steal from your brother or sister when you fear God? It's not possible. For any of you who have taken anything that is not yours, I call upon you to return it and top up with something extra.
The Archbishop raised the concern while delivering his Easter message to Ugandans in a press conference held at his residence in Namirembe. He reminded Christians to live a righteous life and as well stick to the values of the family through avoiding acts of sexual immorality, fornication, defilement, among others.
Homosexuality is already illegal in Uganda, and we appreciate Parliament in upholding that position. LGBT relationships should not be promoted in school curricula, in cartoons, in so-called human rights workshops, or any other forum as normative.
The Archbishop further tasked Ugandans to be hardworking, arguing that is the only way they will be able to defeat poverty. The former Prime Minister, John Patrick Amama Mbabazi, who also doubles as the chairman of the Church House Date Fundraising Committee, said Ugandans should resurrect with Jesus Christ by being peaceful.
This Easter, we will resurrect with the risen Lord, and that he will help us to become positive instruments of peace, seeking to build a kinder, gentler, and resilient society in these challenging times.
He later gave assurance to the faithful that the remaining church house date of 16 billion shillings will fully be cleared between September and October this year, following President Museveni's promise to give them a hand.
And we have a commitment from a reliable source, dependable, that has already supported us, the President of the Republic, in this effort, that this money, by September, October, this calendar year, will be found and will be left in no debt at all.
Meanwhile, the Right Reverend Bishop of Mukono Diocese, Enos Chitokagodo, has urged all church stakeholders to utilize church land by practicing farming, poultry, and other investments as a way of preventing encroachers.
Let us use the land. We are encouraging them to plant bananas and coffee. The other side, it's an income generating project.
While addressing the press today, the bishop said investing in land is a good strategy as it prevents land wrangles as well as encroachers and also helps the church to earn money.
God is land. It's not our land. Because it's not mine, it's not for our priest, it's not for anybody. But it's God's land that given to help the church give services to the community. So it's my prayer. And also these people, the land grabbers, please, in this resurrection, this Easter day, may the Lord touch them.
He has also expressed his gratitude towards the government for helping them as a church in fighting encroachers. The bishop was delivering his Easter message to Christians. He further tasked Christians to celebrate Easter in a way that will please the Lord. Report compiled by Jaliat Namuwaya and Joanita Nakate for the news.